Good day, everybody. Today, I am going to be showing you how you can edit a drop-down list. In my previous videos, I showed you how to create a drop-down list in Excel, as well as how to remove it if you need to remove it. Now, I'm going to show you how you can go about editing that list. Before I do that, I am going to remind you to subscribe if you have not subscribed before, like, share, comment, and please remember to watch the ads. I'm using my previous worksheet that I have worked on before, and what I did was to edit it so that I can show you how you go about editing this same form or any form of your choice, any Excel file of your choice. So in my previous file, I had the question, which month were you born? Now in this form, I have, were you born in this summer? If so, select the month. In the previous file, I had all the months because you had to select which month you were born. So I had to have all 12 months. In this case, I would need to have only the summer months, which would be June, July, and August. I therefore need to edit the list to include just those 3 months of the summer. To do that, of course, you have to click on the cell that has the list that we are working with. So that is the cell G3 for me, the cell with October. Now to edit it, I have to go back to the data tab. So you have to click on the data tab and then under the data tools group, you will select data validation. When the dialog box pops up, you're going to ensure that you are on the settings tab. Of course, it is a list, so we're going to let it remain as a list, but in the box that says source, we're going to change it and edit it to have only the 3 months that we need for the summer. So what I'll do is to click in the box, and of course, the source with the months will appear. But what I'm going to do is to remove that range, click on the arrow that is right beside the box under source, and then just select or highlight June, July, and August, because those are the summer months that we need you to choose from. Then I'm going to click back on that same arrow that is in the box for the source, right under the data validation section. So what you notice now is that it has a different range, only the range with the 3 summer months. When you are through, you will then select OK. We can check. If you notice, the drop down list icon is there. When you click on it, you will only see June, July, and August. You are no longer seeing the 12 months of the year that were there previously, because we edited to only have the summer months. So if you were born in the summer months, if so, you have to select whichever month in the summer month you were born, if you were born in it. So this is how you go about editing one type of list. Now I'm going to show you how you can edit the short list. The list before was a long list, and this list that I'm going to show you how to edit now is a short list, which had just yes or no. So what I'm going to do is to show you how you can edit it by adding another option. And the other option I'm going to add to this question is previously. Are you a civil servant? The options there are yes, no, and I'm going to add one to say previously, meaning I was a civil servant before. So how do you go about editing? First, you have to click in the cell that you need to edit. the seller has the list that you want to edit, of course. Once you have done that, you then go back to the data tab, and then under the data tools group, you will select data validation. Of course, you're going to go back to the source, and then what you will do next is to put a comma and then put previously. Remember now, when we are editing shortlist, we usually just type the options, and the options we had previously were yes, no, and we are now adding one more option to the list to edit it basically. So we just separate it by a comma. So we put a comma right after no, and then put previously, and then when we are through, we will then select OK. So now if I should click on that drop down arrow icon right beside yes, you will now see yes, no, previously. So there you go, guys. That is how you go about editing a long list and a short list in Excel. Thank you for watching. Please remember to like, subscribe, share, comment, and remember, guys, to watch the ads. Thank you, guys.